No, I know what I'm trying to say.
Sir, I haven't asked my questions. Right. I did ask you my questions and you ran away.
No, I know. I know, because Issa was talking.
To get, no.
No, Issa was talking.
No, you left. So I especially came to get some answer to my practical questions. So what is the phrase man says?
Yeah.
What is the phrase man says when man have a muta marriage with the woman from 3 o'clock to 5 o'clock?
Okay. If the woman knows Arabic language, then she has to say it the Arabic language.
What is it?
She says to you, I marry myself to you for a dowry of X, like £1,000, whatever. Dowry of X for a number of days of X. Then you say, قبلت الزواج. So in Arabic, she says to you, زوجتك نفسي على مهر فلان لمدة فلان. And then you say, قبلت الزواج. I accept the marriage. And then she becomes your wife. And this is what she says. But there's rules to it.
Just a moment. You have the marriage from 2 o'clock to 5 o'clock.
You're giving me an example. Are you giving me an example?
Sir, I'm giving you an example. Okay. I'm just trying to understand.
Okay.
You have the marriage from 2 o'clock to 5 o'clock. And then you are paying her £4,000.
No. You can give her anything. So it doesn't have to be money.
That's what you discussed.
Yeah.
She is happy with the 1,000. You are happy too with the 1,000. Okay?
Yeah. It's an agreement.
That's what you agree.
Yeah.
Do you need any witnesses for that marriage?
No, you do not need any witnesses for this marriage.
So you don't need any witnesses?
No.
So the Muslim woman, she was over there. You can simply go to her and then say, I want to have a muta marriage, and you don't need to go to mosque. You don't need to get any witnesses. Correct?
Correct. However, if she's never been married before, and she's still like virgin and that, then you have to get the permission from her father.
Okay.
But if she's been divorced, then you do not need her father's permission, because it's in her own hands.
Okay. So, if she's virgin.
If her father is dead, you have to get her grandfather's permission.
She has to be a virgin.
No, if she's not virgin.
Just a
moment.
So, let's say she's not a virgin.
Yeah. Okay? Like she's been divorced.
So you.
She's been divorced. Because if she's not a virgin in a haram way, and she's still under her dad's permission, she has to be divorced.
I really want to understand the wisdom of Allah in this.
No.
I titled it as a prostitution.
No.
But if she's, you are not going to listen to... No, I haven't brought my question to you yet.
But it's not clear.
I haven't... Listen.
I'm saying if she's a virgin, if she's lost her virginity through a haram way, then you still have to get her father's permission. But if she's been divorced, then you do not. If she's been married and then divorced, then you do not need her father's permission.
Now listen to my question very carefully, okay?
Yeah.
I seriously want to know the practical side of it. Therefore, I am asking.
Why you want to know?
Get on the line. I'll talk to you.
Yeah. I want to know everything about it.
So, woman, girl, she's virgin, okay? You go to her father and then say, your virgin daughter, she's only 9 years old.
No. What is 9 years old? Hold on. Wait. Why are you bringing
into the wrong Muslim?
No. 9 years old? No. It's not allowed to be 9 years old. Why are you saying 9 years old? You're not allowed. What's 19? No. The allowed age is 18. The allowed age is 18.
18. According to whom?
Of course,
she's talking about Aisha.
I'm not talking about Aisha.
Yes, you are. Why you mention 9 years old?
Why you mention 9 years old?
Aisha was 18, not 9.
18 when she was married. 18. We have a fax to the wrong Muslim. He doesn't believe in that.
He's been Muslim for the last 4 years.
No, I don't know what to talk to you.
You're talking about your time, right?
So, in here, here's the documentary. It's been done by BBC. Okay? In Iran, it's about the muta marriage.
All right, can I say something?
No, sir, just wait.
In
here, your clergy...
He's not a fake cleric. I know. I heard it on the radio.
Just a moment.
He's a fake.
In here, your guy.
It's fake. It's fake.
Can you listen to what I'm saying?
But it's fake.
9 years old plus.
No,
there is
fake.
No problem at all.
That's
according to Sharia, there is no problem.
No,
do
it's
what
fake.
You desire, says the classic Sayyid Mustafa.
This is fabricated.
Just a moment. You said, as soon as girl is the virgin, You no. need to go to the father to get the permission.
She can be a virgin. Are you a virgin?
You go to
can
the
be
father.
A 50 years old virgin.
Do you go to the father?
It doesn't have to be 9 years old.
And then say
so you're trying to say after 9 years old they lose their virginity? Sir. There's girls 20 they're virgin. There's 30 they're virgin.
The priest is not allowed to get married. You know that. The priest
is not allowed to get married. But with your fish head, I thought you would bring your brain to speak as
God. In Christianity, the priest is not allowed to get married. Is that right or no?
Bring your ears together.
Is that right? The priest is not allowed to get married.
Trying to question the prostitution under the
what prostitution? How is it prostitution?
So, therefore,
it's marriage.
You are not allowing me to speak. Therefore, I cannot get my
case. Saying it's prostitution.
It is prostitution. It is prostitution.
On what basis are you saying it's prostitution?
For the prostitution, do you need to go and get the permission from the woman's family or man's family? No. For the mutah marriage. For the mutah marriage. Do you need to go and get the permission from her family?
Yes, it's a contract.
Listen.
It's a contract.
No, you can't make. He said already no to that one.
Yes,
no,
you do. Contract. You do.
No, you need a contract.
You said unless she's virgin.
No.
You said unless she's virgin.
No.
If she's not virgin, you do not need
she has to be a virgin when you put her. What that means, the woman has to be a virgin, not married.
No,
no.
No,
a woman has to be virgin.
No, virgin, no. Yes.
No,
so for
no.
the virgin woman,
no,
you pay
no.
Why not?
No.
How much do you pay?
I don't pay nothing.
No.
You pay nothing?
No.
No.
So you just have sex free?
Down. No, no.
You have a place, you no. pay.
Dowry is Hindu. Dowry is Hindu, babe.
Is it Hindu?
You have sex free.
Dowry is Hindu.
Not sex free. In the contract, it is Islamic
way. How much do you pay?
The Quran says.
How much do you pay?
In Quran is mentioned.
That's my question.
It is a Quran.
How much do you pay for the Muhammad?
I don't pay. I don't pay
nothing. You don't pay?
It's a contract. It's an Islamic way. It's an Islamic halal way.
Yeah.
I don't pay nothing.
Why is Surah 4 verse 24 talks about pay their wages for the pleasure you receive from the sexual relationship, you go against the Quran.
Go look at your Catholic priest who will never
I'm
get married.
Talking about the priest.
Why the priest doesn't get married?
I'm talking about go look the at prostitution. Allah
okay, go look at your priest.
As the mutah nikah. So I am asking the simple question.
The, why the priest
how many times did you have a mutah? Did you have a mutah?
It's not Shia, it's not Sunni guy.
Did you have a mutah?
Give the baby.
It's
not for this guy, it's not for this guy.
How much did you pay for it?
Why are you talking about Sunni people?
Just a moment.
Sunni is not practicing.
Just a moment. It's Surah 4, verse 24, not in the Quran.
Alright, which day is today?
Do you use
Quran? No, which day is today? Sunday. Listen, Sunday. What
do
are you supposed to be? You're supposed
Quran?
To be in the church.
Do you use different
You're supposed
Quran?
To be in church.
We don't use different Quran. Quran is
what you preach. You don't even follow
it. You're using each other's Quran.
Are you recording for her?
Catholic priest never get
what you preach. You don't even follow it.
Don't touch
me, sir.
I'm simply asking the question, which Allah, with all of his wisdom, with all of his mercy, titles as a temporary marriage, which is nikah mutah, which means you marry with someone from 2 o'clock to 5 o'clock, and then you pay for the pleasure you receive from that sex. And then both of you go to your own way. I think that is ugly, I think that is disgusting, and today it is identified as the prostitution.
Explain to us your religion.
I'm just trying to justify that. Isn't that shame? That's very shame. Here's the alternative for you people.
Shame for what?
We don't believe that.
God made Adam and Eve for one another.
I clean myself 5 times a day, you know that.
Until death parts them. Yet, Muslim thinks that's very funny for them to just go
because he's talking shit, bullshit. Every single week. Every talk about your religion.
You identified Quran is what is
but
not
talk
bullshit.
About your religion.
Muslims are calling their Quran bullshit.
You trying
and
to attack
Muslim
Islam.
Friends are practicing that so-called
what
bullshit.
Question? That's easy.
But
that's easy. They pay you.
Call that
let me explain
as a
to you.
Prostitution. People, keep yourself away from Islam. Prostitution is ugly. And when Islam steps in and then gives that as the divine law of Allah, still it is ugly.
You don't believe Allah. What are you talking about?